The color slice in the previous exercise gives a sense of the limits of what colors can be displayed on your monitor. This is a different kind of color space. We won't get heavily into this diagram, which shows what is called the CIE-XYZ color space, but I want to point out a few key bits. Along this curved edge are the pure spectral colors. The values here are the wavelengths of light that produce various colors. You can in fact see the colors of the rainbow as you move along it: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and so on. You might also notice a funny artifact along here and here. I find these lines will show up more strongly if I look at my computer screen from a different angle. These bands, which are called Mach bands, are something you might run into every now and then in computer graphics. It turns out that the pure spectral colors on this outer rim are not something a monitor can actually display. The pixels in a monitor each have a red, green, and blue component, and none of these components is a pure spectral color, but rather a mix of differing wavelengths of light. What this means is that our monitors have limits on the colors that they can display. What is happening outside of these dashed lines is that the illustrator is just faking it by picking the best possible color and repeating it on out to the edge of the curve. What the diagram of displayable colors looks like is this. This triangle is called the device's color gamut. The vertices are the same RGB vertices we use to form our own color triangle, and is a slice out of the color cube. This whole area reminds me of seeing advertisements for TVs on my television. The announcer would talk about how their new TV's image was brighter, sharper, and with richer colors. On the screen, they'd show some bright, crisp video. But of course, I was seeing this video with my old TV, so there wasn't much point in them showing me anything in the advertisement at all. The key takeaway in all this is that the RGB color space is directly connected to the monitor, and that monitors have limits as to what colors they can display. The idea of a color gamut is also important in printing. For example, for high-end printing, custom inks can be used to increase the extent of the gamut.